the experience level, with the languages they speak, and then they'd spit out across a variety of interfaces. So we sent a video set of text messages every day and says, you know, here's a nearby better paying job. You know, we've created an IVR system so that these things can be seen on an automated voice piece. And then, you know, there's also, you know, a multilingual website and some application work that we've done with the handset makers. And these are all the ways that, you know, we create different interfaces that allow us to reach, you know, differing levels of income and literacy across our job seeker population. It's a freemium model, right? So for the job seekers and the employers, right, they both get to search and register themselves for free. For the job seekers, if they want data that's pushed to them, they usually pay about 2 cents a day or rupee a day via the telcos, and we do a rev share with them. For the employers, which is where we see the bulk of the revenue coming up, the job post is free. This is different. All the other major job sites in India, Naukri, Monster, you know, there's a fee that's associated there. But like those other sites, if you want more services, right, if you want to do an advertising piece, if you want to broadcast this, if you want to get telephone numbers of those people right now, you know, there's things that you pay for. And then we do a little bit of lead gen things too for the services that do require more labor, like verification, guaranteed placement. You know, we have a partners that we're beginning to set up with folks all across the country. And then finally, the part that's really been interesting, just as our database has gotten bigger, we're at 170,000 job seekers. We've added 70,000 of those since December of this year, or last year. You know, that as that database gets bigger, the advertisers begin to get more and more interested. So, you know, we find that educational institutes in particular, right, folks that are selling vocational training at the 5,000 rupee a pop, right, really want a corpus of people that they can market to, and also they really want help in terms of getting those people placed after they've gone through these training things. So we think that's a third revenue stream that, that could be interesting. You know, we were founded in 2007 largely as a web company. You know, in 2009 we began to look more and more on the mobile in conjunction with Airtel. We've been investing a lot in 2010 in terms of this call center and adding more telcos for distribution in there. You know, as I said, we've had 550,000 positions that we've done to date. You know, we've added 165,000 job seekers. Again, there's about 1,000 that is added a day, so you'll see that number keep going up. You know, we send out 1.5 million alerts a month, right, about these jobs to the carriers. We register a whole lot of employers. In terms of social impact, and the surveys that we've done with hired job seekers, you know, everybody is changing job for a reason, right? They're changing jobs because they earn more money. On average, that thing is about 20.1%. They're changing jobs because they want it closer to their house. We've seen an impact of about 14 minutes a day of reduced commute. And also status, which is frankly a little more difficult to quantify. But, you know, it's your marriage prospects improve if you go from being a cashier or going from being a maid to a cashier at a grocery store, right? And everybody wants that aspirational piece. Everybody wants to work at a multinational that they can tell their friends about. So these things matter a lot too. And then as an information portal, we think there's more that we can do with data to empower job seekers to know about what opportunities are the right ones. In terms of key financials, you know, last year we made about $50,000. We did a seed round. We raised $180,000 last year. We're seeking a Series A this year for raising $1 million. We expect to break even point in July 2013. And you can see the breakup of how we see the revenue in this financial. So, you know, we see, as you said, there's about an equal in the next year that we'll see between employer services and job services. So the job seeker, that's the rev share that we're getting via, you know, alert services with the telcos. And we're spinning up these kind of premium services now. And then we can see the ads being pretty minor. But as you see that, you know, as we go forward, the employer sales, we think, increase a lot more. And these telco relationships are not really for the revenue, but for the user acquisition, especially those other partners. And then in terms of the expenses side, you know, the single biggest one is, you know, we think that that sales force, in terms of really reaching out to those employers, needs to get bigger. When you look at the other job companies that are out there, they spend time. So, you know, Naukri's got 1,300 people that are involved in sales there. Finally, in terms of the team, myself, I was at Microsoft for 9 years, came out to India in 2004. Veer, I guess it's a good time to join me on stage. Basically helped run a seed stage investment firm here. Maya was the director of partnerships. She's, you know, has a lot of experience in terms of General Lakshmi and helping us, you know, work with other MFIs and other institutions in terms of trying to get them to act on our behalf. And then, you know, a call center team and a dev team. In terms of our advisory board, you know, Ash over at MapUnity is one of the strongest people in terms of technology and government we know. Freeman Murray, you know, basically ran a very successful company that consulted in the 90s, and then ran the IR Accelerator program at Ahmedabad. Ravi, you know, used to run Microsoft and just joined the board of Infosys. And then my stepfather, a serial entrepreneur who I started the company with. And then furthermore, our seed round investors, so if you're interested in investing, these are the people you'll get to know. Essentially, you know, this last round, we went to a very small seed fund, so Freeman's in there, Bloom, based out of Mumbai, and then some contacts of ours, basically your old colleagues and interested folks in the Valley. And so that's it. So we'll take some questions. If there are.
Thank you. Just over the first one. I did not mention it, but I read new material. So the question is international development part of your plan? I hope the answer is not.
Not in this round. I mean, in short, for this Series A round, we expect to be focused on India. And sorry, the question was, what's our international plan? And in the near term, it is none. And then we call that the B round, right? So in short. That said, the one thing I will say is, when we first began, we were sort of the only digital company focused on how do we make the informal market efficient. There have been some other players that have sort of cropped up worldwide since then. So there's a company out of Mexico City called Assured Labor. They did pretty well at SOCAP this year. They've raised about $1 million. There's another company called Suktel that's raised about $2 million and mostly donor funding based out of the Palestinian territories. And then, obviously there's CellBazaar, right? That was a classified service largely focused on the informal sector, but also that just got sold to Telenor, based out of Bangladesh. And so there's some activity beginning to happen in this space, internationally. But that said, we think India's a plenty big market. There's lots to do and lots to get the model right here.
I'm just looking at and 1 million raise will get you there.
We think that gets us to, very comfortable for 2 years. And yes, we think the 1 million raise allows us to build up that sales team, partnerships broadly, both retail and in the telco space. So we think that gets us to 2013.
And then geographically, where will you? So you're in Bangalore. So where?
I mean, we operate all across the country right now. In terms of, we do expect that as the sales team grow, there will be regional sales officers.
And so related to that, what will be your Bangalore versus other cities?
The other cities will predominantly be just sales offices. We'll keep the call center and we'll largely keep all of the development and management piece in Bangalore. That's how we're thinking about it.
From the current traffic?
Very little bit, because we're sort of tracking that on a month-on-month basis, and it matters based on the promotions that are also happening today. But the big cities are that you do expect right now, which is basically tier one cities. But we do have a whole lot of job seekers that come from places like Bihar that are looking to immigrate as well, and where those, the resonance of finding jobs over your phone, I think given the dearth of opportunities there, have actually been really popular. And so we see a lot of demand in those places too.
Sean, yeah. Where will the number of job seekers go in 2 years, from 170K to?
4.5 years out, we'd like to get to the 18 million mark, right? And we don't think that's that crazy. Right, like Nokri has 25 million today, right? And especially as the number of folks that are getting on mobiles, the number of folks that have access to the web, plus the IVR pieces, we don't think 18 million in a 4 year time frame is all that crazy.
What will the number in 2 years? I ask this because if I want to know where will you be at the end of your current round.
Yeah, I think we're projecting around three and a half, four. I don't have that one off the top of my head. But there's a trajectory that looks like that. And that's mostly dependent on partnerships plus the SEO piece, right? In terms of how well does, do we get found on the internet? And then how well do we engage our partners to really push these things out and give them monetary reasons to help us as well?
Yes, Son.
Yes.
The question is that most of your job, how often do you actually upgrade your database?
What do you mean by upgrade? It's a matter of usage, right? So you can think of it as, let's say somebody sends us a text message, right, that has a PIN code in it and a job category and a salary. And then, we'll tell them things like, hey, if you want a different city, SMS us jobs in a different city, and then they'll get a different set of pieces that come back there. And so then the other piece of we jobs that they're interested in, and then what we're usually doing is giving them a telephone number and then they're calling that person.
So is that number SPs or?
In general, people are looking for jobs in one city, right? I mean, they know, they either live in that city already or they have relatives in that place. I mean, that's the general piece. The thing that people will do is they'll change the categories they're interested in, right? For two reasons there. One, you know, you'll see this a lot. Sometimes people will go and get a degree in computer science, right? And that degree in computer science, really, what's the salary and status associated with that job? And could they go ahead and do it? The other thing that we do see, which is a much smaller percentage of our users, but very interesting, are people that change their categories all the time, right? And they're basically looking up job information on behalf of other people that they know, right? And that is, we think there's things that we can do to leverage that guy. And so one of the things that we'd like to do is begin to think about reseller networks, right? Where this person who's obviously engaged in it and obviously using that data to basically help the rest of their social network, how do we turn them into a real advocate of us and help them make more money, right? And so it's one of the things that we'd like to invest in going forward.
Sorry,
is that
it?
I mean, today is largely via advertising with our partners, right? So, you know, if it's Airtel, it's a set of things around, you know, putting up a set of postering and signage that happens there and beginning to drive people. And then going forward, we think, you know, there are other forms of advertising that if we have a set of retail centers where somebody can come in and buy access to job information, you know, there's an effort that we may need to do to drive them to those places, right, so they can gain that. And that may be over other more traditional mediums. Yeah, so I mean, because we're a mobile service, right? And we actually tend to go a little higher, right? So when we began, you know, we thought a lot about it's aspirational, it's 18 to 22, right? And for them, you know, I would call it the 8th to 10th level is really kind of the sweet spot in terms of where we see a lot of interest, right? So this is cashiers, sales jobs that pay $5,000. Like, you know, one good example is, as all these telcos have come into India, they each want to set up shop in a given state. And when Uninor comes into West Bengal, they need to hire 1,000 guys, right, that are going to go around to every local Kriana shop and make sure that you can get a SIM there. Well, you need people that can go do that, right? And you're not hiring necessarily a super high-end guy for that. It's a low-end sales job. And so, but you are paying $5,000. And that's actually a pretty good job, right? If you've come from the village and you're in that area, they need geographic distribution, and suddenly you're working for a phone company, right? And that has meaning, right? So, you know, we have a lot of jobs in that kind of, you know, split this bound, right? So to your answer, most of the things I've put into that low-end, entry-level, business-related work, from office helpers, right, to sales folks, to cashiers, and then, you know, about, at this point, 15 or 10% of the job posts are really in that domestic category that we also have, which is the sort of more traditional.
To facilitate further networking after this, if in case there are some queries that cannot be answered, and you would like some assistance in terms of either the presentation or any contact details, you could write to Rashmi, and I would request you to note down her email ID. It's rpillai@intellicap.net, and Intellicap is spelled as intellicap.net. So any information that you have missed out or would like to, in terms of either contact information or any of these presentations, you can write to Rashmi. Okay, moving on. The next company that we have is Bihar Development Trust, and I'd invite Mr. Dev Kumar.